169, same means we got shots fired at 415 ASO.
With that, I'll take a couple of questions.
Is there any indication?
Can you expand on the misinformation? There's a lot of rumors online, and how that may hinder the proper investigation.
Yeah, listen, I mean, we have a responsibility as law enforcement organizations to run down each and every lead, to debunk them, to determine whether there's any validity to those leads. And so, as I told you, we have a significant number of those. The investigative effort is massive. We continue to do it, but rumor and supposition doesn't help. And so those true tips and leads of things that people know are imperative to this investigation. But just because you think you know something doesn't necessarily mean that you do. If you have factual information that you can provide us in regards to this investigation, it would be helpful to us. Thank you.
I understand that motive is still unclear. However, can you confirm that investigators, while recovering these numerous electronic devices and cameras, they may have recovered a video in which the suspect may have alluded to his motive, or any type of video regarding the shooting?
I'm not aware that we've recovered any such video.
Understood. Sir, have you been able to resolve the question of whether he had any help, or whether there was an accomplice, or can you eliminate the question of whether you are specifically trying to find somebody else?
Okay, the question is, can we confirm whether there's an accomplice or not? I can tell you this, we're very confident that there was not another shooter in that room. What I cannot confirm to you today, and what we continue to investigate, is whether anybody else may have known about this incident before he carried it out. You're going to have to speak up. I'm sorry.
Concerning the question of tannerite, what is being used for? Was there any indication that anything was found in the vehicle for his home, that there was a chance this guy was putting together IEDs, the shrapnel with containers or anything else like this? Or was this just a standardized package?
Right. The question is about the tannerite that we found and whether we believe he was trying to make it into an IED. I can tell you we found it in the condition that it was, and it did not resemble an IED.
I don't know if you guys talked about this or not, but in the video of the Mandel Bay, have you reviewed all that to see if somebody else came with him or all those days prior?
The question is, have we reviewed the video from the Mandalay Bay? I can tell you that there's voluminous amounts of video from many different locations. We have reviewed it, and we have not located any other person that we believe to be a suspect at this point.
Was there any indication that someone else used his card key to get into his room while he left the hotel?
The question is do we know that anybody else used a room key for the hotel room, and we do not believe that happened.
Can you comment on whether the shooter had any mental health diagnoses, whether the reports he's taking Valium or another medication?
The question is about the medical status. That is another aspect of the investigation we're keenly interested in, and we're continuing to investigate that.
Are you looking at whether he was...
Go ahead, sir.
On the timeline, so the security officer tells you on the timeline that he was shot at 10:18. That's when he tells you he was shot. When was he shot?
I can give you the exact time off the timeline off camera. I don't remember. I don't have it in front of me as we sit here. I'd be clear about the timeline, right? What the sheriff and I have both explained to you at different times is information that we had initially, we went back and reconciled it with what was on the body-worn camera as well as what was in our computer-aided dispatch, the CAD data. And so all of that timeline that we represented to you is what we have to the best of our knowledge today. I'm sorry, I cut you off, ma'am.
Okay, I was just wondering, are you looking into the question of whether he was kind of obsessed with the month of October since he bought the guns in October and his lawsuit was dismissed in October?
I can tell you that our investigation is focused, I'm sorry, the question is, are we looking specifically at the month of October? The answer to that is we are looking at every aspect from birth to death of this suspect in this case.
So just to go back to the security guard, are you able to tell us what time the alarm went off on the 32nd floor and why it was going off? And is it at all possible that the security guard was shot before Paddock was firing into the crowd?
So you have a two-part question. Is what time did the suspect go up, or I'm sorry, the security officer arrive to check the door and why? The question, or the answer is that the door alarm went off, indicating that the door was ajar. So the officer was dispatched up to check that specific time. We have it. I don't know what it is. And I'm sorry, your second question?
Is it possible that he was shot before Paddock was even firing?
The question is, was the security officer shot before the suspect was shooting into the crowd? The answer to that is yes, we believe he was shot. that we believe that he was shooting into the crowd, and then the security officer was shot during that event. I'm taking two more. Go ahead.
The percentage of injuries, I know we had discussed this earlier. Do we know how many people were actually shot versus the trampling injuries or anything else?
That's a question that you're going to question is, how many people were shot versus other trampling injuries? As you well know, the number that we continue to look at, both for dead and injured, and we still have obviously critically injured people in the hospitals. You notice I'm not giving you a number because that number continues to change every day. People are being discharged from the hospital, and I'll let the coroner answer those questions because he's best provided to give you the information in regards to whether, somebody received a gunshot wound or another type of wound.
Mr. To clarify a report about a key being used, his room key being used when his car was out of the garage, did that happen?
The question is, was his vehicle being used while his room key... was his vehicle out of the garage while his room key was being used? I'm not aware of that information, sir. No. Last question.
I thought you might address this at the beginning, so do it at the end. Well, maybe 22,000 people have belongings there. When are they going to get it back? When are they going to, maybe the FBI and Metro can tell us?
Yeah, so we've answered that question a couple of times, Ken, but the question is, when are people going to be able to get their property back? As you can imagine, we have thousands of pieces of property that were left on the field that particular day. We are diligently working to find how it is that we can appropriately document the evidence where it lay and catalog it, collect it, and then find the mechanism to get that back to the people that actually own it. I believe we're still probably about 4 days away from allowing that to happen. And the final thing I'd just like to close out by saying to you that it's really imperative that the listening public have a very clear understanding that there are still a number of people out there that know that something looked out of place. Someone may have been acting suspiciously that night or in the years prior, the months prior. Somebody that may have seen something or knows something, much to like the FBI SAC mentioned, if you know something, you need to say something, please provide that information to us at that 1-800-CALL-FBI, and we'll continue to update you as this investigation continues. Thank you very much.